Okay, so good morning students and welcome to the another lecture for this engineering graphics. In the last lecture we are discussing about we have started with the new unit, so that is our isometric drawing. Okay, so let us revise the previous lecture. So I have told you what is meant by this isometric drawing. Okay, so not a case. Yes, so we are discussing about this one. Okay, so what I have told you, what is this isometric drawing? So initially we have seen, we have converted the three dimensional drawings into two dimensional drawings, so we have called this as an orthographic projection. This is called as orthographic projection problem. Okay, two dimensional, three dimensional drawings are converted into two dimensional drawings. If we take the reverse of this one, if two dimensional drawings are given, that is in the form of front view, top view, front view, top view and the side view, then so then we can convert that two dimensional drawings into three dimensional drawings. So conversion of two dimensional drawings into three dimensional drawing, that is called as the isometric drawing. Okay, that is called as the isometric drawing. Okay, so it is a simple definition, conversion of three dimensional drawings into two dimensional drawing, that is called as the orthographic projections, while the conversion of two dimensional drawings into three dimensional drawing, it is called as what? The isometric drawing, or we will say isometric drawing, and then it is converted into isometric projections and the view. Okay, so we will see that one. Okay, now here in isometric drawing we have three axes. Here we have three axes, so we will consider this as a three connected axis. Now the included angle between these three axes is 120 degree. Okay, this is 120 degree, this is also 120 degree. Okay, and this is also 120 degree, and these three axes denote the three dimensions, that is length, width and the height. Okay, and the included angle between the two axes is 120 degree. So all these three angles are equal, so we call that as a iso. Iso means what? It is equal. And metric means what? It is dimension. Okay, metric means what? It is dimension. So that's why it is called as a isometric drawing. Okay, so iso means equal, so all the angles are 120 degree, 120 and 120 degree. Metric means dimensions. Okay, so equal dimensions is there in this drawing, so that's why it is called as the isometric drawing. Okay, now these three axes, these are called as the isometric axis. Okay, this is three axis, so this is one, this is two and this three. These three axes are called as the isometric axis. Okay, now let us see the next thing. Now here we have drawn that one, so this is L. Suppose we here the nomenclature is something L, suppose D and H, these are called as the isometric axis and they denote the length, width and the height. Okay, then afterwards the lines which are drawn parallel to this axis, so this line is drawn parallel to this axis, then this line is drawn parallel to this axis. Okay, then this line is drawn parallel to vertical axis, then this line is drawn parallel to D axis. Okay, so the lines which are drawn parallel to the isometric axis, these are called as isometric lines. Okay, these are called as what? The isometric lines. And after drawing these isometric lines parallel to the isometric axis, we get the planes. We get planes here, and these planes are called as isometric planes. Okay, so three things you have to remember here. One, the main axis. Okay, so that is called as the isometric axis here. Okay, so L, D and H, these are called as the isometric axis, which denotes the length, width and height dimensions for three dimensional object. Then the lines which are drawn parallel to this isometric axis, these are called as isometric lines. So these are the lines. Okay, so after so this line, two lines, then this and this line, it is parallel to L and H. So these are what? This is called as the isometric lines. And after drawing these three lines, after drawing these isometric lines, we get the planes. So this is plane 1, 2 and 3. So this is called as isometric planes. Okay, these are called as the isometric plane. Then afterwards we have discussed about the isometric scale. Now this isometric scale is used to reduce the dimensions. Okay, so it is used in the isometric projection, so we'll see that one. In the isometric drawings we have two types, one is called as the isometric view and another one is called as isometric projection. Okay, so these are your the MCQ questions. Okay, so this you have to remember. Isometric view means what? If the two dimensional drawings are given, okay, if the two dimensional drawings are given, so this is suppose length is 50 and height is 50, and if you are taking the same dimensions, or the that means the actual dimensions from the two dimensional drawing, so 50 here and 50 here, so then we get here isometric view. So that means if you take the actual dimensions of the true, this is called as the true dimensions. Okay, So if you take the same dimensions from the two dimensional drawings, and if you have constructed the three dimensional drawing, so then it is called as isometric view. Okay, now if you have reduced the dimensions, if the 50 get reduced, if you multiply this 50 by 0.815, okay, 0.815, and that 0.815, it comes from what? It comes from isometric scale. It comes from the isometric scale. So if you multiply this 50 into 0.815 or 9 by 11, okay, so then the dimensions get reduced, so it is less than 50 now. And if you draw then three dimensional object using this dimension, then it is called as isometric projection. So isometric projection uses what? Isometric scale. Okay, and from that we got that number, that is what, 0.815. So if you multiply the actual dimensions by 0.815 or 9 by 11, then the dimension get reduced. So, okay, so this three dimensional object is smaller than this object. This is actual, this is the same, this is of same size, this is of same size, and this is what, this is smaller than the this object, three dimensional object, first object, this is first object, and this is second object. So second object is smaller than first object. Okay, why? Because we have multiplied by the isometric scale index, that is 0.815, so that its dimension get reduced. Okay, so we have to use isometric scale for isometric projection, and we are not using any isometric scale for the isometric view. You have to take actual dimensions for the isometric view, while the reduced dimension for the isometric projection. Okay, so remember this one, this is very important, and they will definitely ask you in the MCQ questions. Okay, so isometric view uses the it takes the actual dimensions from the front view, top view, and side view, while isometric projection, it uses the isometric scale, and the dimension, actual dimensions are multiplied by 0.815 or 9 by 11, and then that value is taken for the construction of the drawing. Okay, so this isometric projection, three dimensional object which is created using isometric projection, it is smaller, or it is also called as reduced dimension. Okay, we have reduced the dimension in isometric projection. Okay, so this is smaller than the first one. This is with actual, this is with the reduced dimension. Okay, then afterwards we have seen how to draw the some shapes here. Okay, so rectangle shapes, how to draw that one, we have seen that thing. Okay, so let me show you that part here, how to start with the isometric projection problem. So what we have done here, okay, so what we have taken here, so the first step to construct the isometric project, we are in our subject, we are dealing with isometric view. So we will take the actual dimension. We are not using isometric scale here. Okay, so in our syllabus we have isometric view only. Okay, so we will take, that means we will take the actual dimension for constructing the three dimensional object, not the isometric scale. Okay, then we have, so okay, so now what is the first step to construct the isometric view? Now we'll discuss about view, isometric view. Okay, isometric view. So first we have to draw the one horizontal line. Okay, then afterwards you have to draw one vertical line here. Okay, here you have to draw one vertical line, okay, like this. Okay, then afterwards you have to take here 30 degree angle. Here you have to take 30 degree angle on both sides. Okay, so 30 degree angle here and 30 degree angle here. Okay, so why we have taken here 30 degree angle, I will explain that afterwards. See, then draw the inclined line here, 30 degree line. Okay, this is our origin here, this is our origin. So 30 degree inclined line. Okay, this is first line, 30 degree. Okay, and then the second line also the 30 degree. So this is the basic construction to start any isometric view problem. Okay, so you have to take 30 degree angle on both sides. Okay, why we have taken here 30 degree angle and 30 degree angle here? Because we know that the included angle between these two axes, isometric axis, is 120 degree. Okay, we have just seen that is 120 degree. So remaining angle is how much? It is 60. So 30 on this side and 30 on this side for symmetry. So this is the 30 degree angle, and 30 degree angle is there on both sides. So this angle is 30 degree. Okay, and this angle is also 30 degree. Okay, and this included angle is how much? It is 120 degree. Okay, so angle between the isometric axis is 120 degree. Okay, and then the remaining angle is what? This is 30 and this one is 30 on the both axis. Now see, we got three axes here, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, vertical axis always gives us the height. We have three dimensions. We have length, we have width, and we have height. Okay, so vertical axis will always give us the height. Now you can take length here on this axis, or you can take length here also. On both the axis, you can take the length. If you take length here, if you take length here, then width comes here. Okay, width will come on the another axis. If you take length here, okay, if you take length here, then width goes on the another axis. Now wherever you take the length, in that directions we'll get what? We'll get the front view. In that direction we'll get the front view. And wherever you take the width, in that direction we'll get the side view. Here we'll get which side view? Here is the front view. Observer is here. So this is what? Left hand side view. This is the left hand side of the observer. So this is left hand side view. Okay, this is left hand side view. Okay. Now if you take length here, then the width will go here. Okay, let us check that one also. Okay, so like this. See here. So this is our, we have taken like this. Then we have taken here 30 degree angles on both sides. Here this is 30 degree, and this one is also 30 degree. Okay. Now this one is height. Now I am taking length here. So width will go on this axis. Now wherever there is a length, so we'll get here what? We'll get front view here. Now this is front view. Now if we take the front view, now this direction, this is the right hand side of the observer. So here we'll get which view? We'll get here right hand side view. Here we'll get what? Right hand side view. Okay. So if you take the length on this axis, then here is the front view, and we'll get here right hand side view. So you have to see which view is given in the problem. If right hand side view is given in the problem, then you have to take length on this axis. Okay, and if the left hand side view is given in the problem, then you have to take the length on this axis. So here this is the front view, and then you have to take width here. So then this becomes what? This becomes left hand side view. Okay, vertical axis is always height. So there are two types of problem. One is when the left hand side view is given in the problem, you have to take length on this axis. Then we'll get left hand side view. Left hand side will come here. If right hand side is given in the problem, then you have to take length here on this axis. Okay, then this becomes front view, and this becomes right hand side. Okay, so this is very important. Okay, if you take length here for the right hand side, then you will get here left hand side. So this is not the correct position of the correct position for taking the dimensions. Okay, so you have to be very careful while taking the dimensions like this. Okay, so be careful about this one. Okay. Now let us see how to draw this one now. So we will start with the basic construction. So I have just demonstrated you the how to start with the problem. So we have to take first horizontal line. Okay, then we have to take the vertical perpendicular line here using the ruler scale. Okay, so here there is the perpendicular line like this. So this is our height now. Okay, so this is our origin O. Okay, then we have to take what? We have to take the 30 degree angle on both sides. Okay, the reason for why we are taking the 30 degree angle, I have just told you. Okay, so let's draw the vertical line again. It comes up to here. Then this is 30 degree angle on this side and 30 degree angle on this side. Okay. Now draw the 30 degree inclined lines. Okay, so this is first 30 degree line, and then on the another side we have to take again 30 degree line. Okay, using ruler scale, join this 30 degree line here. Okay, so these are the two lines. Okay, and okay, so this is over there, and we got now our three axis here. So this is our vertical axis. I'm just extending that one. So okay, so we have now three axis. Now let us, I am taking here, suppose this is my length, okay, vertical axis is always height and this one is what, width. Now since I have taken here length, so this is my front view, this is my front view, okay, this is front view, and on this side, on this side I will get what, which view, this is left hand side, so this is, I will get here left hand side view, this is left hand side view, okay. Now let us take some the example. Suppose we have given the front view, suppose we get the front view as a square, 50 by 50, okay, so this is our front view, and we'll get also the top view as the square, so this is also 50 by 50, this is also 50 by 50, so this is our top view. Now we know that for front view, what are the dimensions, we will get a horizontal length and vertical height. For front view, we will get horizontal length, vertical height. For top view, what are the dimensions? Horizontal length and vertical is what? Vertical is width. So these dimensions you have to remember. Okay. So for front view, the horizontal dimension is length, vertical is height. So what is the length? L is equal to 50. So L is equal to here 50. So we have to find out first three dimensions similar to the orthographic projection. So L, H, H for from front view, we will get two dimensions, L and H. So H is also 50. So this is H is also 50 here. Okay, now then from top view we'll get a width. Width is vertical. What the vertical dimension in top view gives us the width. So this is also 50. So all the dimensions are 50, 50, and 50. Okay. Now we have to construct this, that we have to construct the three-dimensional object isometric view from this front view and top view. So how we'll construct this one? See, we have length, width, and height. Okay, we have three dimensions here, L, H, and W. So we'll take the dimensions. Okay. Now let us take the dimensions here. Okay, so we will take the length is equal to 50 now. Okay, so length is equal to 50. So on length axis, okay, on length axis, you have to take L is equal to, you have to take length is equal to 50 here. So I'm using a different color, suppose like this. So 50. So it goes up to here. So this is 50. So I have taken here 50 mm. Okay. Now the height is also 50. So you have to take height is also 50. So you go for the height. This is also 50. Then this is the height. So measure the height. That is also 50. This is 50 here. Okay. So length and height. So that is equal to 50 now. Okay. Now the next one is width is what? Width. So width is also 50 here. Okay. So width is also 50. So this is 50 dimensions here also. So on isometric axis, we are taking the dimensions length, width, and height. Okay. So this is 50. So three dimensions we have drawn. Okay. So length, width, and height. So this is length is equal to 50, height is equal to 50, and the width is also 50. So we have taken the dimension. Now we got here three intersections. See, here 1, 2, and here this is three intersections. Okay. Now these are what? These are our isometric axis. Okay. Now we'll draw the isometric lines. We'll draw the first isometric lines. So now, suppose we have here two intersections. Okay. Now keep your roller scale parallel to, now we have to draw here vertical lines. So keep your roller scale parallel to the height. Keep your roller scale parallel to height. Okay. Then from here, from this intersection, you will get first isometric line. Then from here, you will get a second isometric line like this. So two vertical lines parallel to height. Now parallel to length. Now from this intersection, this direction, I have to draw this one line this direction. So parallel to length. So you have to take that line parallel to length here. Okay. Okay, so here this direction, see, you have to keep your roller scale parallel to length. Okay, parallel to length, this direction like this. Now from this intersection, it is parallel to length. From this intersection, it is parallel to length. Okay, now I want to draw the line in this direction. So this is in the direction of width now. So you have to keep your roller scale parallel to width. Keep your roller scale parallel to width here, like this. okay, this direction, like this. So you have to keep your roller scale parallel to width, and then draw the intersection from here, or draw the line from here parallel to width. See, we have drawn these two lines. Now we got two intersection here and here. Now from this direction we have to draw the line in the direction of length. So again you have to, and from this intersection we have to draw the line in the direction of width. So this direction, so it is already there parallel to width. So you have to take this like line, something like this. Okay. Now from this intersection parallel to length. So again you have to, you have to keep roller scale parallel to length. Okay, parallel to length. Then you have to roll it, and then you have to draw the line parallel to length. Now see this one. See what we have drawn. Then we have constructed the square of 50 by 50. So all the dimensions are 50 by 50. Now in front view, see this square is visible, and in top view this square is visible. So this is front view and top view. Okay. So in front view L and H is visible. In top view this is L and this is what W. This is what W. Okay. So we will rotate it. We will make this vertical. So see, this is two views are given, the front view and top view. Then from these two views we have drawn the three dimensional object, and we have taken what? We have taken the actual dimensions. We have taken the actual dimensions. So this is called as isometric view. Okay. Now, so this we have drawn. Now suppose we have to draw the circles on this isometric view now, or in this three dimensional drawing here. So how to draw the circle? So the method to draw the circles in isometric drawings is by four center method. This is called as four center method. You can't directly trick compass, and we can't directly construct the circle here. Okay, in orthographic projection we are directly taken the compass and we have drawn the circle, but here you can't directly draw the circle. Suppose here this is circle is there, here it is circle is there of diameter 50 mm. Circle of 50 mm diameter. So we have, this is circle of 50 mm diameter. This is the diameter of the circle is what? 50. Okay. So how to draw the circle? We can't directly draw here circle. Okay, using the compass. So you have to follow here one method, that is called as the four center method. Okay. So how to draw the circle of 50 mm diameter? Now see, first you have to construct the square of 50 by 50. So we have constructed here the square of 50 by 50. Okay. So here this is 50 and this one is 50. Suppose we are constructing the circle on this plane, here plane. Okay. So then afterwards we have to take the center. You have to take the center of all the lines here. Okay. Now take the center here. So this is 25. Okay. This is 25. Then take the center of each line. Okay. This is the 25. And vertical also 25. This is also 25. Okay, this is also 25. So you have to take the center here and center of this line also. This is 25 and 25. Okay. Similarly, from the of the vertical line. So height-wise. So height-wise also you have to take the center. Okay. So here it goes something like this. This is 25 here, and here this is also 25. Okay, so see we have divided the square into four, that is the centers. Okay, so so first step is what? First see the diameter of the circle. Diameter of the circle is what? 50. So we have constructed here 50 by 50. If the diameter is 30, we have to take here 30 by 30. Okay, okay. So the here the diameter is 50 there. So this is 50, this one is 50. Then afterwards you have to construct here the square, and then you have to take the center point of each line here. Okay, so I have taken here the center. Okay, so I will give you the nomenclature. Suppose these are our four centers. This is the four center of the lines here. Okay, we have taken. Now the next step is, after constructing this one, after constructing this, now we have to join here. Now we got here one plane. This is called as isometric plane. Now here you have to join the longest diagonal. Here what is the longest diagonal? This is shortest, and this one is what? The longest diagonal. So join the longest diagonal. The next step is, we have to, after taking the center point, we have to join the longest diagonal. So join the longest diagonal. So this is the longest diagonal for this plane. Okay, in this plane this is the longest diagonal. for this plane, this is the longest diagonal. Okay, so diagonal will change. You have to be careful while selecting the diagonal. Okay, here also we'll take the midpoint of all these lines, and then you have to join the longest diagonal. So here this is the longest diagonal here, and this is the longest diagonal here. Okay, so for this plane, this is the longest diagonal. Now after joining the longest diagonal, the opposite corners. This is the opposite corner, and this one is the opposite corner. So this is center C1 and C2. This is center C1 and this is center C2. Okay, so these two centers you will get after joining the longest diagonal. After joining the longest diagonal, we'll get two centers, C1 and C2. Okay, so two centers are over. Now we have to find out what the next two centers, because the method is what? Four center method. So two centers are already we have got here. Now we have to find out now C3 and C4. So how to find out C3 and C4? So from C1, joined the opposite midpoints. Join the opposite midpoints. So we have find out the midpoints of all the lines. Now from C1, join the opposite midpoints. What are the opposite midpoints for C1? It is 1 and 2. So you join the opposite midpoints here. Okay. From C1, you join the opposite midpoints. Okay. So here. So this is C1. Okay. Then from C1, and then you have to join this here C2. Here you have to join here C2 now. Okay, this is C2. Okay, so from C1 we have joined the opposite midpoint. Similarly, from C2 we have to join the opposite midpoint, that is 3 and 4. So here you have to use C and 4 now. So from C2, this is C2, 4, and then we have to join C2, 3 here. Okay. So see what we have done. First of all, we have drawn the square because diameter is 50. So we have drawn 50 by 50 square. Then we have taken the midpoints of all the lines, 1, 2, 3, 4. So then afterwards we have drawn longest diagonal. After drawing the longest diagonal, we got opposite corners as center C1 and C2. This is the diagonal, so these are the two opposite corners. So this is C1 and C2. Okay. Then from C1, we have to join opposite midpoints. So C1, 1, then C1, 2. Then from C2, opposite midpoints are 3 and 4. So C2, 4 and C2, 3. So after joining these three these lines, so you will get here on the diagonal, you will get the common intersection. So that is our C3, and this is what? This is our C4. So here we got now the two centers here. We got here two centers, that is C3 and C4. Okay. So now the four centers are over now. We got here four centers. That is our the four center method. Okay. So from C1 to 1. So from C2, 4 and from C2, 3, we got here common intersection on the diagonal. That is our center C3 and C4. So now this is the process to get the four centers. This is the process to get the four centers now. So now once you get the four centers, now you use the compass. Now use the compass. Put your compass on C1. Okay. Now take the radius is equal to C1, 1. Take the radius is equal to C1, 1. Okay. So center, now we have to use all the four centers. Now from C1 to one radius, and then draw the arc. Then draw the arc between this C1 up to 2. Okay, so up to here, you have to draw the arc. Okay, then afterwards, use the center C2. Use the center C2, take the radius C2. C2, 4, and draw the arc between 3 and 4. Okay, draw the arc between 3 and 4. Okay, so here it is. Let me increase the dimension. Okay. So here you will get the arc something like this. Okay, so you will get, if you draw it correctly, so you will get here, it will intersect here at 3. It will intersect here at 2. Okay, so what we have done, we have taken C1, 1. C1, 1, we have drawn the arc here. We have taken C2 center, 4 as radius or 3 as radius, arc between 3 and 4. Now next is you have to use C3 center. So C3 center and then 4 or 1 radius. 4 or 1 radius. So like this, so here like this, you will get arc like this. Okay, similarly, you have to use C4 center and radius is equal to 2. Radius is equal to 2 or 3. Okay, you have to draw arc here like this. Okay, not the complete arc. It is the arc, with arc is only between 2 and 3. The arc is only between 2 and 3. Okay, arc is only between 2 and 3. Okay, like this. So what we have done, we have taken C1 center, then radius is 1. We have drawn this arc between 1 and 2. Then we have taken C2 center, 4 radius. We have drawn the arc between 3 and 4. Then we have taken C3 center, 4 radius or 1 radius. Then we have drawn arc between 1 and 4. Then we have taken C4 center. We have taken C4 2 or C4 3 radius. We have drawn the arc between here. So like this, we have to construct the circle. So in isometric view, the circle appears as an ellipse. Okay, the circle appears as an ellipse. So it will come something like this. Okay. Now how we'll draw the circle here now? Here, how we'll construct the circle here? So here again, you have to take the 4 midpoints of this line. You have to take the 4 midpoints of the line. Okay, so this is 25, this is 25, this is 25, this is 25. Okay, so already this is 3 is there. So we will take, this is 2, we will take 1, 2, 3, and this is 4. So 4 midpoints of the line. You have taken 4 midpoints of the line. Now what is the next step? You have to join what? You have to join the longest diagonal. So join the longest diagonal. So then opposite corners become center C1 and C2. This is C1 and this is C2. Okay, so we have joined the longest diagonal, opposite corners are C1 and C2. Then from C1, you have to join the opposite midpoints. So C1, then C2, then from C2, opposite midpoints are 3 and 4. So you have to join like this here and like this here. So you'll get here the common intersection here and here. So this is our C3 and this one is our C4. Okay, now use the center. Okay, now you use the center C1. C1 and 1 radius, you have to draw the arc between 1 and 2. C2 center and 4 or 3 radius, the arc between 3 and 4. Then from C3, this radius or this radius, you have to draw the arc between this one. C3 1 or C3 4 radius. Then C4 2 or C4 3 radius, you have to draw the arc between like this. So you'll get here the ellipse something like this. So this is our the circle. Circle 50, it comes like the ellipse on the isometric view. Now how we'll draw the circle on the top view here on the top surface. So here also you have to find out the midpoint. So this is, these are the midpoints. Okay, so suppose this is 1, this is 2, then this is 3 and this is 4. And here what is the longest diagonal? So this is the longest diagonal in the top view. What is the opposite center? This is opposite center C1. This is C1. Suppose this is then C2. This is C2. From C1, opposite midpoints, you have to join opposite midpoints from C1. From C2, you have to join the opposite midpoints here and here like this. So you'll get here common intersection on the diagonal. So this is our C3 and this is our C4. Okay, right, here C4. Now use the centers C1. Okay, now use the centers. So from C1. So from C1, the arc between 1 and 2, so like this, you will get arc here. From C2, you will get the arc here, like this. And from C3, you will get the arc here, like this here. And from C3, you will get the arc like this here, like this. Okay, so this is called as the 4 center method. See, on all these surfaces, 1, 2 and 3. So in isometric view, we have to draw the circles in these 3 surfaces only. So this is the process for construction of the circles in the color. So you let me show you that the part here. So you please refer the video. That means I have already posted on our Google Classroom. So here, this is our first video, that is isometric introduction and 4 center method. So here, this is the introduction for the isometric view. Okay. The difference between isometric and isometric projection and isometric view. And afterwards, so you will get what the 4 center method. So here, this is 4 center method. It is explained here. So you see this one. Okay. So the same thing, whatever we have taken 50 by 50. So diameter may be anything. So you have to take the dimension particularly, and then you have to follow this the method. So here you see, we have taken the longest diagonal. This is C1 and C2. Then from C1, joining the opposite midpoints. We are joining opposite midpoints here. Okay, from C1. Then from C2, this C and D. These are the opposite midpoints. So you have to join these opposite midpoints. Okay, and then you have to. We'll get the common intersection on the diagonals. So this is our C3 and C4. Okay. Okay, after joining this, you will get the common intersections on the diagonal. So this is our center C3 and that is our center C4. Now use C1 center, A radius or B radius. C1 A radius or C1 B radius are between AB. Then C2 center radius is C or D. You have to draw arc between CD. And then C3 C radius or C3 B radius arc between this C and B. C4 D or C4 A radius arc between this here. So here you see, we will draw the intersection. Okay. So here first we'll take the C1 A or C1 B radius arc between A and B. Okay. So this is the arc between A and B from C1 center. Okay. Arc between A and B only. Then from C2, C radius or D radius. Okay, these both are same. So arc between CD. Okay, you have to take the arc between CD. Okay. Okay, so see, this is the complete circle now. We have drawn that one, but it appears as an ellipse. Okay, it appears as an ellipse. Okay, now here, if you refer the on another plane also, we have drawn the circle. So refer this video and you see, draw this on your sketchbook. Okay, at the same time, I have posted the another the assignment for orthographic projections. Okay, so you have to complete the 3 problems from the videos I have posted on, we have posted on the group. Okay, so you have to complete that assignments this week. Okay, so assignment number 1 and 2. Okay, and we also the you have to be